When I was a kid, when I was a teenager, when I was miserable, I could take my guitar out on the porch and play and express my emotions. And when I heard great classical repertoire, it could vicariously express emotion for me. And so music was really about emotion. It was also about structure, because I love structure. I mean, that's the computer programmer in me. So the things that I was most attracted to in music were slightly at odds with the music that was in with the dominant power structure when I went to Juilliard. It wasn't really considered cool to be interested in learning to write tonal music, for example. A teacher who shall remain nameless, when I brought in a piece in E minor for guitar at one point, he said, key signature doesn't mean for sure that you don't have any musical imagination, but it's not a good sign. Things that I think made the 70s a really special period was that electronic instruments were too expensive for most people to own. But for a lot of us, the way to get access to electronic instruments was through shared studios. So there was community, there were interactions between people. To be like working in the studio and okay, I'm coming in and Eliane Radique is just finishing up and she shows me what she's doing and then I take down what she's doing and I put up what I'm doing, and then when I'm done, Reese Chatham comes in and he's like, oh, you could do this and this, and by the way, you know, we're trying this, do you want to come and play with us? And I mean, things just happen, you know, between people. And I think that's made the 70s a really special period, the fact that there were so many shared studios where people worked together, interacted with each other, commented on each other's work, helped each other with their work. How would I get it to do this, that kind of stuff, as opposed to everybody sitting there by themselves in their room with their computer. Life back in the dark ages when I was young, when you had a great deal of time to focus on what was happening in your mind and information could proliferate, amplify itself and take form in your imagination without that much interruption from outside, at least fairly often. You know, walking home from school, for example, every day you had your mind to yourself. Our culture is at this point full of people who are focused outward and are processing incoming material all the time. So you get musical forms which are remixes and mixes and sampling and all kinds of making new pieces out of pre-existing materials rather than starting with some sound that you begin to hear in your imagination. And I'm a little concerned about this because being able to focus inward and listen to what your own auditory mechanism wants to hear, listening for what it wants to hear, what it would generate on its own, is, I mean, there's just nothing like the imagination. You can do processing of stuff coming at you till the cows come home, but are you going to get something that's really the expression of your individuality and your sensibility the same way as listening to your own inner silent inner ear?